Good morning, everybody. I want to give a shout out again, once again, to the Revs for having me here to share with all of you. Welcome to this moment in your lives, a moment that will never be the same person sitting next to you, the same music being played, the same date, an original, authentic, unique moment in time. Look around you. Take it all in. This is who we are right here and right now. Today, I want to talk to you about moving from competition to feeling confident. So many people talk about other people like they're so much better than them, or they have more talent than they do. I want you to know that you too are bright, unique, and original light that is shining bright right here. And yes, while it's good to celebrate and be happy about other people, good morning, Miss Ava, I also want you to recognize your own accomplishments. You may be talented in some areas. You may be attractive. You may have other gifts. There is something great and unique about you. And celebrate other people, but don't forget who you are. I hear people often say, "You should see how beautiful my sister is. You should see my coworker, they're so talented and amazing. You should see my fellow student, they are so wise and brilliant." And yes, hear me say, that's wonderful, but I want you to know that we all have our gifts to share. And that's what Reverend Karen was talking about, diversity. We all bring something to the table. I have personally made the mistake of putting someone up on a pedestal where I put them so high and I think that they're so brilliant and so bright, and it's true, but I forget who I am, and I kind of feel like I don't measure up. Have you felt that way? And like I said, it's okay for others to have different abilities and different talents than you are, but what you're recognizing them is who you are. So you see, we can't really recognize or see something in someone else unless we can be it. Now, that can work both ways. I'm going to talk about that a little bit in a minute. But it's our responsibility. It's our responsibility to know that we've attracted people into our lives for a reason. And just as I mentioned, that can work both ways. So if you're feeling like somebody is maybe a little less than, maybe you're feeling a little less than about yourself. And I'm here to tell you this morning that you have an undeniable treasure that exists within each and every one of you. It exists in not just being there, but it exists in who we are. There is a beauty, there is an abundance, there is a wealth, a plethora of information that begins and resides within each and every one of you. And I invite you today to look at the possibility, the potential of something being born anew, that we now move from competition into the new idea and an opportunity of confidence. What I would call taking that next step into my life, into your life. Now, I'm choosing to talk about this clearly this week because I know my purpose. And I know your purpose, whether or not we use it, or even if we know it, is to celebrate exactly who we are. It's to be authentic and to become more awakened than ever before at this time and this place. And so as I take that next step, I'm calling it the evolution. I have a student who has come to me for some coaching, and she attends the center, and she said, "I love everything about the center. I love the classes. I love the Sunday mornings. But when people ask me what I believe, I'm not quite sure how to address it. I'm not quite sure what to say." So I have an easy answer. I have an easy answer that I always use. And what I tell them simply is, we are the Christ consciousness. You are, each of us individually, already the Christ consciousness that we're seeking. It's nothing outside of us. And then I play a game and I tell them, do you want to see how that works? And inevitably, people always shake in the affirmative and say yes, because who doesn't want unlimited power, unlimited joy, unlimited love? And so I ask them to just close their eyes and be in the moment and recognize that right now, all that they are is Christ consciousness, and all you have to do is stop judging. Simple. Right here and now, just let it all go. Just stop judging. And if you have accomplished that, bravo, because you are one of the people who have come here to be that. My grandbaby this week, I had the great pleasure of taking him to a couple of soccer games. And I was so proud to watch him. He's three, so imagine the swarm. I was so proud to see him playing soccer. But what was more amazing was to see my son watching him play soccer. And what I discovered was that there were kids, some who were confident, and some who were not so confident, and some who were reserved, and some who were exuberant, like our dear Stephanie here, and outgoing and all over the place, each uniquely expressing in their own little ways, some supported by moms and dads, and some by grandparents. They weren't worried about competition. They weren't even worried about confidence. You see, they were just being present in the moment. They weren't seeking or looking for anything. They were being everything. They were being all of it, you see? They were all of it completely. They were expressing that Christ consciousness that we innately are without years of programming or years of deprogramming. They were expressing it, and they knew why they were here. So watching them reminded me of what we teach here at the Science of Mind, at the Center for Spiritual Living. We teach Science of Mind. We teach exactly who we are. We encourage people to be in the moment. Yes, have you experienced that with the treatment? Just be in the moment and be totally present. And when you start to recognize that Christ consciousness, that's who you know and remember that exists within you. We are at a powerful place, and when we take total and sole responsibility for who we are and what's going on around us, just like the babies on the soccer field, we start to recognize and know that we are part of a creative, entire universe itself. And although it may not revolve around us, or it's not centered around us, we are part of it, and we become and are the director of it if we choose. If we choose. Now, the only thing that prevents us from that, the only thing that prevents us from that is the experiencing or the anticipation of fear for the future and the reflection and memory of past experiences that has brought us to this place, to bring us to that centered place of Christ consciousness. The kids on the soccer field, they had no past experience to judge their present experience. They were creating their memories right there and right now on the soccer field. It was clean, it was brilliant, it was a fresh start, it was new awareness, nothing to judge. And that's exactly what we talk about here at the center. You being perfect, whole, and complete, that's about talking about the truth of who you are. Because without a past and without a present, life is just perfection itself. In the totality of the present moment where all life resides, which is where treatment is done from, that present moment. Because all there is in that moment is the perfection of life. And it's our ability to bring that experience, positive or negative, of the past into the present today in anticipation of what our future is going to look like. You hearing me? Here's where we can start to reflect on not being so intimidated by other people's gifts and being confident in who we are. And this reminded me of a joke of a woman who was married to a mayor of a small town. And they were out for their Sunday drive with their convertible down, and they realized that their car needed gas, and so they drove to the gas station. And wouldn't you know it, that the attendant there was one of the wife's ex-boyfriends. And they had their niceties and exchanged their hellos and goodbyes. And when they pulled away, the mayor held his wife's hand and said, "Aren't you glad you didn't marry him? If you did, you'd be married to a gas jockey." And she said, "Actually, if I married him, I'd be married to the mayor." Wait for it, wait for it. You see, when you know who you are, when you know who you are, a person that has that Christ consciousness, there is nothing standing in your way. I want to tell you that God has good things, life and planned in store for each of us. God, the universe, wants us to have everything, wants us to experience and have everything that our dreams can hold true for us. Always our highest and best, always. But you got to throw back your shoulders and throw your head up high and act like you want it and like you're ready to receive it. You got to walk confidently. You got to talk with purpose. And we're going to teach people how to treat us. Do you know we do that? We teach people how to treat us. So if you have a less than mentality and you're walking with your head down and your shoulders shrugged, well, I'm telling you that I'm not important. Our body language speaks volumes. The way you carry yourself is sending messages. You can be as talented or gifted as you want, but if you don't believe it, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how it's going to look for you, because people are going to receive it that way. So get in the habit of speaking with people with intention, and look folks in the eye when you're talking to them. That's exactly how we know that we're connecting. It's exactly how we know that we are one, just like Reverend Karen was saying. I want you to know that they, other people, may be of this world, but they are not the only ones of this world. You too are part of this great gift of life. So I want to start carrying myself like royalty. I'm going to carry myself like the queen. I'm not talking about arrogance or ego or anything like that. I'm not saying I'm better than other people. However, I want to be secure in who I am, and I want to invite you to feel the same way. So when we talk about whole, perfect, and complete, that's exactly who we are. Sometimes we may feel that we're not better than anyone else, but I'm here to tell you, you're certainly not less. You are here with purpose. And throw your shoulders back and be with intention. It doesn't matter how many degrees people have behind their names or who they know or who they're associated with. You've heard me say this before. You're part of a spiritual family. You're part of a family that is growing and growing and expanding. And we didn't show up here to be average or mundane. No, no, no. We are here to walk that walk and talk that talk and be worthy of all of the splendor and goodness that the world has to offer, that God, that the universe has to offer. I remember going to a Agape Revelation conference once, and I had the great honor of meeting Brother Ishmael Tete from Africa. Picture this if you can. He walked in all of his colors. Can you see the colors? The African colors? He walked in a room of 2,500 people. And everyone looked at him. It wasn't because of the colors. It wasn't because of the colors that he was wearing. It was because he knew who he was. And I had the great pleasure and great honor of sitting with him in a pod, an intimate pod of six people. And when I sat with him, he was so reassuring and he was so gentle. And you know why? Because he knew who he was. He knew that he was a messenger, that he was a gift, that he was representing God. And I looked at him and I saw, if he can do that, I want to do the same thing. So can I. So from that time on, I consciously made a decision that I would be a representative for God for good. You've all heard me say that I'm an ambassador for God. We're all ambassadors for God. But if I go around feeling less than, not enough, or comparing myself to other people like I don't add up, like other people are better than me, is that representing God very well? When Brother Ishmael Tete walked into the room expanded. Have you ever felt that? When somebody walks into your space, it grows. When he walked in, it expanded. Now, there were people who were, I'm sure, wealthier than he was, more educated, more talented, more handsome, whatever. But he walked in like he had it going on. He waved to everybody like he was the queen. He had that confidence. He was not intimidated at all. He knew he was a child of God. So those thoughts of ordinary or usual or just average, they didn't come into him. The words of you're exceptional, you are one of a kind, you are unique, which is what I said to you when we came in here this morning, when I invited you to look around and experience this moment, because it is a unique moment, just like we are unique and one of a kind. Now, it wasn't so much what he did, Brother Ishmael did, or what he does. It was the fact based solely that he knew who he was. And when you understand who you are and whose you are, well, then you understand and you're coming from a whole different place and you're driving out that intimidation and that feeling of inadequacy or inferiority. And you throw your shoulders back and you lift your head up high and you know that you qualify and you know that you're here with purpose. Now, he's human, so I can only imagine that some mornings Brother Ishmael Tete might wake up and say, I'm not enough. I don't know if this is for me today. I don't have it in me. And then that reminds me of a quote that I heard from Lady Gaga once when she said, I wake up in the morning and I feel like every other insecure 24-year-old girl. And then I say, girl, you're Lady Gaga. You get your butt up and go walk that walk and talk that talk. And that's what we're here to do. You don't have to be talented to feel good about yourself. You don't even have to make lots of money. You don't have to be successful or even the prettiest. When you understand who you are, it's in the way you carry yourself. With confidence, with pride. The universal mind has implanted everything that you need to grow your success, your happiness, your wealth, your perfect health. It's provided everything that you need. Everything to flourish, everything to grow. Now, you have to believe it. All of those ideas are there. Do you think the first time that Dr. Deb and Ken invited me to come and speak up on the stage with you, that I wasn't intimidated, that I wasn't scared, underqualified, that's some pretty big shoes to fill. But I did it because they believed in me and it gave me faith in myself. So every Sunday that I come up here, whether I'm doing music or speaking with you, I come up here and I do a little thing that I like to call fake it till you make it. And as you move your steps closer and closer, then you learn deeper and deeper who you are. If you can't find the words, maybe we should say, faith it till you make it. Ooh. Is that resonating with you? Because you don't have to make it all right now at one time. It's about creating the feelings that you want to be. So I'm up here feeling like I want to be. Same thing as when they asked me to be the musical and artistic director 11 years ago. I told them, no. Not me. Not now, not ever. I'm underqualified. I don't have the skill. I don't have the talent. I don't know what it's involved, and I don't think I have what it takes. It took about 20 steps as I walked from the Ancient Wisdom building when they had that conversation with me into the parking lot before I stopped. And I thought, oh, wait a minute. Opportunity's knocking. God is knocking. The universe is knocking. And we all know from the song that we sing at the end of every day that Neil wrote that says, just say yes, that I needed to just say yes. Yes. I needed to say yes, and I needed to take that step in faith. You see, you have gifts and talents inside you, just like I do, that have not yet been tapped into. The potential of your deepest desires have not quite yet been released, but they are there. If we act in fear instead of acting in faith, well, then we're never going to discover what the treasures, the true treasures of what God has put on the inside. The author of The Alchemist writes, "Remember that wherever your heart is, there you will find your treasure." So when Spirit presents to you opportunities to do things that you've never done before, and you have the desire, but you feel unqualified, and you tend to focus on everything that you're not. I'm not trained in that area. I'm not good enough. I tried it once or twice. I failed. I don't want to go through that again. I want to invite you to stop focusing on what you're not and start focusing on what you can become. You're a part. We're all a part. It's in every single one of us. We're a part of the greatest power in the universe, and it's happening inside you right now. Take a breath. It's happening inside you right now. Some of you may be always celebrating others and saying, oh, not now. But God is saying, now it's your turn. Here comes a brand new opportunity that's growing. You're thrust into a whole brand new big idea. And what seemed impossible and might never have been done before, you might be telling yourself, no way, it's too big. God is saying, take that step of faith. Take that leap and discover the potential that you didn't know that you had. You're going to accomplish things bigger and grander than you ever, ever thought possible. Some are you going to sell a best-selling book. Some are you going to own the business that you're working for right now. It doesn't matter, but you're going to start celebrating yourself. We're going to start celebrating ourselves, but we must be ready, and we must be prepared. And when those opportunities come, when they're knocking, don't you dare shrink back. You throw your shoulders back and you hold your head up high, and you say with confidence that I am willing, I am able, and I am prepared to step into my greatness. I have everything that it takes to make it happen. I was walking along the waterfront the other day, and everybody's bringing their boats and jet skis and things are all out. And I saw a jet ski. And I thought, confidence to a believer is what fuel is to a jet ski. You can have a big, huge jet ski with all of its power and capability, but unless you put fuel in it, it's not going to go anywhere. In the same way, all kinds of potential, all the seeds of greatness, you have the ability to rise higher than ever, ever imagined before. We have been placed with the responsibility to rise higher, to be more, to just have the confidence that you can fly and that you can soar. Believe in yourself. When you believe in yourself, others will start believing in you. I want to share with you, when I was at the soccer game, my second soccer game this week, Neil came with me to watch our grandbaby. And at the end of the practice and game, the coach said, which one of the parents will be a volunteer for what time is it, Mr. Wolf? Do you know this game? Well, Neil was like, I will. And Roman's on the stage saying, Papa, Papa. And I'm pushing him saying, you go, Neil, you go, do it, do it. So Neil gets on the stage. He's on the field. He's at one end of the goalpost and the kids are at the other. See, just a sea of 3 and 4 year olds yelling at Neil saying, what time is it, Mr. Wolf? What time is it, Mr. Wolf? And there's Neil at the other end looking at me saying, what do I do? I said, tell them what time it is. Neil reaches in his pocket, whips out his phone and says, it's 4:36. He believed he was so qualified that so did the coach and so did the kids. And it didn't matter about his qualifications because he had the confidence to get out there. When you remember who you are, and what it takes, it's only going to give you more confidence, more propeller to move forward. And then you're going to give others permission to do the same because they're going to see it in you. Then what? Then there's no more need to compete. No more need for the feeling of competition. You've now moved over to confidence. So, some of us may have tried and failed in things in our life. My question is, are you getting back on the soccer field? Are you getting back? Are you looking for new opportunities? Here's to thinking that it's a new day. When we rise up with confidence like that, you're putting fuel into your jet ski, and watch where you go. The possibilities are endless. So when you're applying for that job or any of those things, when you're buying a house or you're just looking for that relationship, know this. God would not have put things in your way unless it was an opportunity for you to grow. And I want you to know that you're totally equipped and ready and prepared to deal with that. So what am I saying? In life, you may find yourself feeling unqualified, feeling inadequate, coming up against a huge opponent. That might be finances. It might be a medical report that might leave you feeling scary or frightened. But what I know is I'm going to keep my faith and know that God always, in all ways, is for me and never, never against me. So friends, you have incredible potential.